Hello students, I told you that Bohr made the postulate that only those energy states will be stationary for which the angular momentum of the electron is the integral multiple of h upon 2 pi. There was no proof at that time, and as a whole this he only forecasted that this must happen there, only then we can explain the hydrogen spectrum successfully. So now I will tell you the proof of Bohr quantum condition. Proof of Bohr's quantum condition. According to Niels Bohr, only those orbits will be stationary in which the angular momentum of electron is integral multiple of h upon 2 pi. It is called Bohr quantum condition. That the m v r equal to n into h upon 2 pi. Here m the mass of the electron, v the velocity of electron, r the radius of the orbit, n the natural number, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on, and h the Planck's constant. So after actually using the de Broglie hypothesis, it could be explained successfully. And as you know that de Broglie gave the hypothesis that every moving particle is associated, the wave is always associated with the moving matter particle, that we call the matter wave, and the wavelength of this wave is inversely proportional to the momentum of the particle. This quantum condition was established by de Broglie. The wave is associated. With every moving material particle. So here also the electron is moving around the nucleus, it means that there must be wave associated with this one. The wave must be associated with moving electron around the nucleus. Since the energy is not emitted by moving electron, it means that there must be stationary wave with the electron. There must be stationary wave with the electron because since the energy is not emitted by the moving electron, it means that there must be stationary wave with the electron. So if we take suppose n equal to 1, then there will be only one wave. N equal to 2, then there will be two waves. If suppose there is n equal to 3, then there will be three waves. If there is n equal to 4, then there will be four waves. They will be like this. This is one wave. It has two wave. It has three waves. It has four waves. It means that as the quantum number increases, principal quantum number increases, the number of waves increases in the orbit. So if first orbit contains only one or the single stationary wave, and the second state will have only two stationary waves, and third state will have three stationary waves, and fourth state will have the four stationary waves. So this is like this. Let's suppose this is the nucleus and this is the orbit. then one, two, three, and four. And the since the wave is associated with this one, it has the wavelength. This is for n equal to 4. De Broglie wavelength. Lambda equal to h upon mv. According to de Broglie, the length or the perimeter of the orbit is equal to the integral multiple of wavelength. Since the one orbit having one wave and second orbit having two wave, third orbit have three wave, fourth orbit have four waves. So it means that the perimeter of the orbit must be equal to the integral multiple of wavelength. It means that 2 pi r is equal to n into lambda. So this 2 pi r equal to n and lambda equal to h upon mv. This we have so much. And from this mvr equal to n into h upon 2 pi. It is Bohr quantum condition. So this proves the Bohr quantum condition, and naturally at that time there was no proof of this one, but when the idea of matter waves was given by de Broglie, then it could be proved that there must be the stationary waves associated with the electron moving around the nucleus, and the perimeter or the circumference of the orbit must be equal to the integral multiple of wavelength. Since only the first orbit have only the single wavelength, and the second orbit will have two wavelength, third orbit will have three wavelength, fourth orbit will have four wavelengths. So this is the integral multiple of the wavelength, lambda. So using the value of this de Broglie hypothesis, quantum condition could be proved easily. So you like, share and subscribe the video. Thank you.